For odd powers, the same set of thinking applies. The only difference is that because you're multiplying the input by itself an odd number of times, all of the negatives don't cancel each other out. So if you have a negative input, you're going to end up with a negative output. So for example, 2 to the third power is 8, but 2 to the seventh power is 128. So clearly, if you have an input that's a positive number larger than 1, the higher the exponent, the steeper, or the higher the point at that value, and so the steeper the graph will be growing for values that are larger than 1. But just like we talked about last time, in the interval between 0 and 1, you have the opposite happening. 1 half to the third power is 1 eighth, 1 half to the seventh power is 1 over 128, and that's a much, much smaller number. So just like last time, the larger exponent actually produces outputs that are smaller in the interval between 0 and 1. And so that's why, again, you have this kind of flattening out shape. Again, just like last time, we have the points 1, 1 and negative 1 common between all the graphs, because if I have negative 1 times itself an odd number of times, the output is always negative 1, no matter how many times I multiply it by itself, as long as it's odd. And 1 times itself an odd number of times is 1. So that's why those points are in common.